Hello everyone, my name is Colleen Greer and I am your Minnesota Collegiate DECA President. I'm here today to talk with you about how to run an effective meeting. So first off, we're going to talk about the several functions of a meeting. Meetings are meant as a place to discuss and evaluate your goals and your objectives. They're a way for you to keep update on current events with your members. They give you a chance to communicate and to pull the group's resources together to make decisions and keep your group cohesive. So now before the meeting, we want to decide the purpose of the meeting. If we don't have a purpose, then we don't need to meet. Once we discuss that purpose, we can create the agenda. The agenda should then be distributed to our members so that they have a general idea about what the meeting is going to be about. So then after that, of course, we need to choose an appropriate meeting time and place so that a majority of our members can attend and keep that on a specific time schedule so that it's very consistent and our members remember which day and which time they're supposed to come to their DECA meetings. We can also be sure that everyone knows where the meetings are being held, so in case there is a different room switch or a different location, they understand so they're not wondering where is the DECA meeting this week. Now during the meeting, we want to greet our members and make them feel welcome. So at MSUM, we start off our meetings with music so that everybody feels comfortable and they aren't intimidated when they walk into the room, so that they know that we're gonna accomplish things and it's gonna be another good week of DECA. We want to start on time and end on time. We need to let our members know that we respect their time and we appreciate them coming to our meetings. So saying, hey guys, we're gonna start 5 minutes, grab a slice of pizza and then take a seat, we'll get started, is a great way for them to know, hey, we're gonna get a lot accomplished this meeting, I'm excited. So we also need to encourage group discussion and get general points from everybody. We want to encourage that feedback and keep the conversation focused and on topic. We can also make sure that everybody knows their roles. This could be the exec board members, this could be other members, so that everybody is clear and concise about what they're supposed to do. Never end a meeting until everyone understands what needs to be done before the next meeting and who is responsible for which task. So if you're delegating out items, make sure they know the resources that they have, when you would like it to be accomplished, and what specifically you're looking from them. We also want to, after the meeting, write up and distribute minutes within 3 to 4 days so that members know what topics were discussed, and if they missed anything, if they can help out with anything, what dates events are going on, and such. We also want to discuss any problems that happened during the meeting. So your secretary can write down anything that people had more questions about or that you need a little bit more information for. And you can discuss that with your other officers and your advisor to come up with more ways to improve that situation for the next meeting. You can also follow up with those individuals who you delegated tasks to, and you can check to see if they understand what they are supposed to do and if you can help them, because if you're able to come to them and say, hey, I have some extra time, do you need any help with such project? They'll probably really appreciate that. Also, it's very important to give recognition and appreciation to the members for their excellent and timely progress. There's nothing like awarding your members or saying, hey, this person did a really awesome job. We should all really appreciate them. It's a great way to keep your members engaged and have an awesome year with DECA. Thank you so much.